Good afternoon. It's a pleasure to be here and present this project, which is a joint project with between Soft Metaphysics and the Institute of Polymer Product Engineering. And as the title already says, we are actually looking at rubber materials, and we wanted to find out how can we tailor these kind of materials to actually improve the damping probabilities. And as been previously said, the inspiration is nature, so I did bring an orange. Maybe I should actually use some orange juice because I'm losing my voice, so I will eat it afterwards. But just to start with, so without damping, actually our life would be literally hard. Just for everyone to be happy, I present a little definition of damping. Damping is actually, for a physicist, a reduction of the amplitude of oscillation as a result of dissipating energy, either by friction or into heat. And this is a special picture just for the physicists, so you will know what I mean when you see these pictures. But for everyone else, actually, in our everyday life, this is what damping and energy dissipation means for us. So when you got to work this morning or when you came to university, you were actually using a lot of different means of transportation. You were walking, you were driving in a car, or you're taking the elevator or the train. And what you can see here, in former time, damping was not so great, so life was really hard. So, and of course, engineers and people and physicists and everyone thought about how can we improve this hard life and actually have good damping solutions. And there is a lot of engineering into damping. So by invention of the wheel, well, filled with air or tires, but as well also shoes or like dampers. And when you look at all these engineering approaches, they often combine a wide variety of different materials that have very different mechanical properties. So in these dampers, for example, you have steel springs, but you also will have liquid, and you have rubber. And here again, you have air and rubber and also some metal parts. This is very different if you look at nature. Nature's approach to damping actually is based on a very few materials. They're actually very, very similar, and they're typically all soft. But the trick, and I show you some examples, so here is my citrus fruit, my orange, and there is our skin, which is also like a damping to the outside, and nuts, for example. There is many, many more, our bones. And what they all have in common is actually that the damping is not just by combining very different mechanical properties of materials, but it's due to their internal structure. So if you look here, this is like a cross-section of the peel of a citrus fruit and this foamy part, which you all know, that doesn't taste very nice. And the interesting thing is here, it's really the structure gives rise to the mechanical properties. And maybe you might wonder, why do I care about the damping properties of an orange? So there is actually a large group in Germany, they're researching why it's important for an orange to be a very good damping material, because when the orange drops from a tree, you don't want it to split open and to degrade. You want it to be taken up by animals and taken away and eaten to distribute the seeds. So orange has a very, very intelligently tailored damping system. What I should also mention, because I said it's a very few materials, also the orange, you all know when you peel it, you have the etheric oils. So there is not only the mechanical parts, the soft spongy parts, but there's also a liquid embedded to give rise to these damping properties. I work with soft materials, and I just put here, they are hard to grasp, and this is true in every sense. First, they're often very squishy, very hard to basically put in a form where you can test them. And if you look here, this is like the very soft materials that is what biological matter is built up. And we are actually working with rubbers. They're a little bit more easy to access, but it's very often very difficult also to determine the properties. Because many of these materials, like rubber we're working with, it contains of long chain molecules, just like biomolecules. And when you have the final material, it's just a network of these molecules. And you have a statistical distribution. That means while you have the same material, it's still slightly different in mechanical properties, and that's very difficult for us to actually access. So I show here a network. This network, which is statistical, you also have a lot of defects which you need to take into account, and this is one of our working horses. It's a silicone rubber material. The good thing, although, about all these soft materials is that they are inherently dissipative. So they, by themselves, are already damping materials, which should make our life much easier to try and now optimize the properties. So I worked a lot on stretchable electronics, and there always is an issue how to protect rigid parts in a soft environment. And we actually, it's just like to give you an idea, you can actually try to tailor the mechanical properties by different approaches. So this one actually we use UV light just to have different density of the material. In this case, we just mix two types of material with different chain lengths or put them in a series or a parallel connection to just change the mechanical properties. And you can see here, this is plotted how much they can stretch, and here is how stiff they are. And basically what you get is if you have very, very long chain molecules, you can stretch them very, very wide. They're very, very soft. Okay. This brings me to our project. So we thought actually there's a lot of projects out there that actually take inspiration from nature, but using hard materials, because obviously they are very nice to work with and you can very nicely put them in a shape. We thought we would do it differently. We would try to actually do everything, these damping materials, from only soft materials, from gels, rubbers, and liquids. And this is also why we need a interdisciplinary team, because we will work with soft physics, with polymer product engineering, but also with polymer chemistry and a little bit mechanical engineering, because you need all to join these different topics to really understand what's going on with the material. The aim is to develop damping systems that are based on these soft materials, and actually to really create these shapes, we want to use 3D printing. Just it makes life much easier to have like everything nicely structured next to each other. And then we want to be able to really have tailored spatial mechanically energy dissipation. So that means tailored damping systems that we can adjust. Okay, so just to give you a little look at how we actually test this. So this is three oranges dropping. And you can see they all have different energy dissipation. So that means they are bouncing off slightly different. So this one actually, it even cracks. It dissipates most of the energy, but it's not... It's actually a failure because it breaks, whereas the other two, they're nicely bouncing off. And what we physicists or even engineers, we look at is actually the storage modulus, which gives a measure for the elastic response of a material, versus the loss modulus, which is actually how much energy is dissipated or how much it can damp. And this is actually usually expressed by a ratio between storage and loss model, which we call Tangens delta, and this is just called the damping, just simply. So what we actually, as a physicist, always like a nice experiment, and when you drop something, you can actually derive stuff from it. And so what my student René, he actually built a very, very simple drop tester. We just drop the stuff, a ball, onto our sample, and we just measure how, from the height the ball is dropped, the height the ball rebounces, and from this you can derive the rebound resilience. Very simple measure to determine the mechanical properties of the materials. Yes, and here, we actually, to really understand a little bit what's going on, we were using two different materials. I did bring them, so you can have a look. And what you can see, obviously, one, this white one, Ecoflex, is very, very soft and it damps very, very well, whereas the Silguard doesn't damp so well. We thought actually blending these two would give us maybe better materials or maybe give us a gradient. But surprisingly, if you look louder at the data, this is the rebound resilience. And what you see, if you have pure Ecoflex and pure Silguard, so which is the harder one, the pure materials itself seem to be damping the best, whereas the mixtures actually get gradually worse, and we even have at, I think it's like 40%, it doesn't damp so well. So this is a surprising result, and actually this is my final slide, because I want to say all this gives us a lot of new things to think about, combining them, And we are actually at the moment investigating how to really understand what's going on with these materials. As I said, it's a statistical material. There's a lot of things to do. First, to have a heterogeneous material where you know how much they crosslink, to understand, really have a defined material. Secondly, how to look into that. Yeah, so I have a study with Cook going on. They're actually looking at this with MRI, where they can actually resolve the crosslinking density with MRI, which is very exciting. And then at least also combining small bits of these two to see if we can really adjust the mechanical properties. With this, I actually want to thank everyone who was involved in this project. And I should also say, at the same time, we're trying to understand this from the mathematical side or from the molecular side. So we're trying to model with by Monte Carlo simulation, molecular dynamics, we try to understand how the chain length and the cross-linking, what the influence could be on the mechanical properties. But I should say, this is very early on. Then actually, this is a study on magnetic resonance imaging. Then this is the group from Institute for Polymer Product Engineering, where we do a lot of more tests. So I just show you a little glimpse. And this is soft matter physics team, where we actually look at the properties. And with that, I would like to thank you for your attention.